New research is shedding light on how much sodium Canadians consume, specifically when we eat out. The study in the Canadian Journal of Public Health shows the average sit-down restaurant meal contains 97% of a person's recommended sodium intake. 40% of all sit-down restaurant items exceed the recommended sodium intake level. And when it comes to the children's menu, meals contain 66% of the recommended levels. For more on what the findings mean for Canadian restaurant goers, we are joined now by the lead author of the study. Mary Skorbatakos of the University of Toronto is here with us. And that's daily, right? Those statistics that I read. So
absolutely,
if you go to
right.
a restaurant, 97% of your recommended sodium intake is gone in that one meal, right?
Just that one menu item. As a matter of fact, that percentage is just based on the entree. The side dish has more sodium.
And you looked at about 9,000 menu items for this study. What did you find?
This study had about 4,000 from 85 chain restaurants from across Canada.
So that's significant. It sounds significant. How significant is it?
Well, on average, we saw levels to be this high, but we also found that there was a large range of sodium. So if you take, for instance, sandwiches, there are some sit-down restaurant sandwiches that have as little as 200 milligrams of sodium, whereas there are others with upwards of 6,000 milligrams of sodium.
And what's the daily intake again?
1,500 milligrams is the daily recommended amount, and 2,300 milligrams is the amount that you don't want to exceed.
So at 6,000, that's almost triple in just one sandwich in some places.
Absolutely right.
And so what are the concerns about that?
Well, we know that high dietary sodium is the leading risk factor for death worldwide. So if you're getting a lot of sodium from restaurant foods, obviously, it can be harmful to your health.
And so what do you think needs to be done here? Obviously, you believe that restaurants need to lower their sodium, right?
Definitely. This study shows the need for a sodium reduction strategy for Canada that particularly focuses on restaurant foods.
And so when you say a strategy, do you mean that, do you think that restaurants should actually be forced to reduce the amount of sodium that goes into our food?
Well, the first step would be to set targets, and that would definitely be a good logical next step.
There's been resistance to that, as you know. Restaurant owners say, oh, you know, we're trying to cooperate, we're trying to lower our sodium levels, but from what you've seen, they're not doing enough.
Well, targets haven't been set yet, and I think that if national targets were set that applied to all chains, it might give them more incentive.
And so what do you think it is that is making restaurants put so much salt into our food?
Well, part of it is the flavor. And also we know that the more salt you eat, the less sensitive your tongue is to salt. So then we crave more.
And so tell us a little bit more about some of the health risks in adults, and then maybe we can talk about children, but in adults consuming, say, 5,000 or 6,000 milligrams of sodium from just eating a sandwich. What does that mean in terms of what could happen to our health?
Well, long term, we know that what happens is a high dietary sodium intake increases your risk for hypertension or high blood pressure. And high blood pressure is a causal risk factor for heart disease and stroke.
And what are the worst foods that you can eat, or the foods that you should probably stay away from?
Well, the interesting thing that we saw in this study is that really there is no nutritional rule of thumb. In each food category that we looked at, there were some items that were high in sodium, others that were low in sodium. So you really have to be aware of the sodium content. You can't really go with a salad every time or a particular sandwich. You don't know.
So it's just really tough to find out all of this.
It is tough.
And what are there particular food chains or types of restaurants that we should avoid?
No, we didn't compare different chains in this study, and overall we do see that most chains have a large range.
All right, so the final question to you, what should Canadians do who want to, are worried about this, and are worried about how much salt is in the food that they eat at a restaurant, but they can't get the information?
Well, the good news is all of the data that we collected is actually publicly available online on the restaurant's website. So if you're eating out frequently, you can go to those chain websites and find the sodium content of the meals you're eating.
All right, Mary, thank you very much.
Thank you.
That's Mary Skorbatakos joining us in studio.